Now that we have presented the decomposition by business capability, let's look at an alternative strategy which defines services corresponding to subdomains. To well explain how this strategy helps decomposing a system into services, I will structure the content like this. 1, explaining the key concept we need from the domain-driven design. 2, compare the domain-driven design with the traditional enterprise modeling. 3, how to link the domain-driven design concepts with services. And 4, discussing the key benefits of using such an approach. DDD is described in the famous book Domain-Driven Design, written by Eric Evans, as an approach for building complex software applications. DDD is centered on the development of an object-oriented domain model. The domain model captures knowledge about a domain in a form that can be used to solve problems within that domain. The domain model is closely mirrored in the design and implementation of the application. The domain model defines the vocabulary used by the team, which is called the ubiquitous language. When applying the microservice architecture, DDD has two concepts that are incredibly useful, which are subdomains and bounded contexts. A domain consists of multiple subdomains. Each subdomain corresponds to a different part of the business. The bounded context is simply the boundary that provides the logical frame inside of which the model evolves. The domain-driven design is not limited to only these two concepts. If you want to have a deep understanding of them and discover other relevant concepts, it is recommended to read the DDD book, or at least its summary provided by InfoQ. You can find the link of this summary called DDD Quickly in the description. DDD is quite different than the traditional approach to enterprise modeling, which creates a single model for the entire enterprise. For example, in the traditional enterprise modeling, getting different parts of an organization to agree on a single model is a monumental task. It means that from the perspective of a given part of the organization, the model is overly complex for their needs. Moreover, the domain model can be confusing because different parts of the organization might use either the same term or different concepts for different concepts or different terms for the same concepts. DDD avoids these problems by defining multiple domain models, each with an explicit scope. DDD defines a separate domain model for each subdomain. To mention that subdomains are identified using the same approach as identifying business capabilities, which is analyzing the business and identifying the different areas of expertise. The end result is very likely to be subdomains that are similar to the business capabilities. The examples of subdomains in the food to go include order taking, order management, kitchen management, delivery, financials, and so on. As you can see, these subdomains are very similar to the business capabilities described in the previous video. DDD calls the scope of a domain model a bounded context. When using the microservice architecture, each bounded context is a service or possibly a set of services. We can create a microservice architecture by applying DDD and defining a service for each subdomain. DDD and the microservice architecture are in almost perfect alignment. The DDD concept of subdomains and bounded contexts maps nicely to services within a microservice architecture. The microservice architecture's concept of autonomous teams owning services is completely aligned with the DDD's concept of each domain model being owned and developed by a single team. Even better, the concept of subdomain with its own domain model is a great way to eliminate the big and overloaded classes and thereby make decomposition easier. Another advantage of using subdomains is the stability they add to the architecture, in addition to the resulting services, which are cohesive and loosely coupled.